Hey everyone, welcome to another Comics Talk. This is Comic Talk 69. We've been at this for over a year now. And in this conversation, I wanted to bring up a couple of little things, but before we get into it, I want to show you guys and do an unboxing of something I bought. Now, the unboxing has already been done, and there was some surprise, but I want to show you what I am actually selling, because someone just bought this beauty. I don't know if you've ever seen this before, but as you can see, it's an embossed cover. It is in absolute great condition. I guarantee you'll need a press. None of the lines here, with maybe a fractional tiny one that might have some sort of edge nick. Also, there is one thing on this comic, which is right up there. If you see it right underneath the 50, just to the left of that 50, you see that little mark there? That's actually production. This comic was never opened, so this was actually something that occurred during production. I don't know if it's common or if it's only this one. Plus, this is also newsstand, and the year is, let's see what year this was, 1993? Yep, 1993. So a newsstand comic in 1993, definitely a good newsstand. Anyway, sold that actually pretty cheap. I mean, I've had it for sale for quite some time. It hasn't really had a lot of traction overall. I've had several offers, and I've always passed them up, and this time around I got an offer, and you know, considering the fact that I really do want to move some of my books, I decided to take it. I mean, I actually sold it in this condition, which is beautiful. $15 was the price, and I originally had it for $20, and I went down $5. I think it was fine. Now, here is what's disappointing. First, I want to show you one of the comics I bought. And this is Superboy number 93. Now, you guys know, if you've been watching my show, that I collect cryptos. That's why we picked this one up. There's the dog. It's a beautiful comic. I think it's 1961, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not going to open it right now, but I think it's 1961. It might have been 1962. As a matter of fact, let me just open it up for a second, because now I'm curious. I see the 12-cent symbol there, and I know that by 1961, they were still selling these at 10 cents. Recently, I heard a podcast that talked about the different pricing, and it was really shocking to find that the prices after 12 cents scaled up in some 1961. So what this tells you is that based on this comic book and Fantastic Four number one, it looks like DC, well, this is December 1961, so I'm not 100% sure, but it seems like DC was the first one to go to the 12 cent mark based on this. Fantastic Four number one was 10 cents. I think Spider-Man was already 12 cents. Amazing Spider-Man, obviously not Amazing Fantasy. So anyway, another crypto for the books. Got a bunch of them now. I still don't have his first appearance, working on it. Now, this was very disappointing, and I'll show you why before I show you what comic this is. You see that? That apparently happened during shipment. And this is it. Captain America. This is 107. And it is a 7.0. It's a beautiful comic, but what's really weird is this thing that happened over here. You see the break? You see that? That is the strangest break I've ever had in anything coming from the post office. It came in the post office. And I'll tell you what's weird too, the box wasn't damaged. So I wrote the seller, you know, because I wanted to see what he would say. Yeah, and I told him, you know, wasn't damaged. Really strange that a hit like this that would have cracked the box like that would not, I mean, the case like that would not be, would not have damaged the actual shipping box. I just find it so hard to believe. I mean, this took a big hit. This is almost like something was dropped on it just because of the way it broke. It really is fascinating. I mean, if you look at the breakage, and it's not, see, at first I thought maybe they tried to replace the ribbon, right? The comic book is actually in amazing condition. I think it's even better than a 7-Up. I mean, if you look at it, that's one of the reasons why I bought it. This comic is like, look at the edges. It's in really, really, really solid condition. I actually think that if I take it out of here, I get it cleaned, and I get it pressed. I don't think this has ever been pressed. For sure it hasn't been cleaned, because look at all the tanning. You know that tanning could actually be taken off. But, you know, I mean, you got to think about the cost, right, for doing all that cleaning and everything to this comic. Because I think tanning is a little bit more than just cleaning. But anyway, it's the first appearance of Dr. Faust. It's a Red Skull cover. It's a Kirby. And it's one of the last Captain America Kirbys that were done during this run. I think he went to 110, maybe 112. I'm not 100% sure. So anyway, that's the shocker, guys. That crack case, what are my choices? If I send it back to CGC, it's going to be $20 to get it. I'm also going to have to, you know, hope that, I think when they open it, they regrade it. I'm not sure 100% if they regrade it if you sent it like this. Now, the good news is that case is so, I would say, not just cracked, but the hit on it is so precise that there's no way they could have done anything to compromise the integrity of the grade or of the comic inside it. There's no way they could have pulled anything out of there and replaced it. I mean, it's just absolutely impossible. And since we're talking about cracked cases, I might as well show you the other one I've got that's cracked. Again, one that could not have possibly been cracked this way to compromise the integrity of what was inside. And still, you know, I may send both of these together. That's why I actually brought this out, because when I do ship them back, and I think I'm going to ship them back and get them re-slabbed at some point. I don't know if it's going to be right now, but inevitably. This is my other one. Fantastic Four 61. It's a great cover. Great Kirby. Look at that. Look at that crack. Thing goes all the way across the back, the front, but the seams are all still tight. There isn't anything on here that describes a seam that would have been opened and something. They couldn't have removed it. You know, you would have to break the seam across, and all the edges seem to be okay. It's just, it seemed like something fell on it again and just cracked the box. Not sure how the heck this happens, but now I got two of them. Okay, guys. Now let's talk about something else that's happening in our market, and that is comics have been going down. If you haven't noticed and you haven't looked, some of the comics that are out there are actually beginning to recede, as you would say. But I'll tell you what, if you look at what's actually receding versus what's still gaining, it's like I said in one of my prior podcasts, where I talked about the fact that, you know, what should you be buying right now? And I talked about Nova and some of those characters. Well, guess what? They're still doing well. You know what's not doing well? Variants, new ones, you know, variants that came out, Peach Momoko. I mean, you know, stuff that, that everyone is constantly jumping back and forth on, trying to catch the flavor of the month. Those things are dying. You know, it's funny because I still see some good pricing on some of those where I thought it would even go further. But I've seen, and I've seen it reported by many other podcasters, I've seen the reductions up to 60% in some cases. I mean, obviously the heaviest hit ones were like the Eternals, Brother Voodoo, some of the, I would say things that were propelled based on, I mean, one of the ones that shocked me was the Marvel Super Heroes Captain Marvel number one from 1960, I think it's 1968, and it's Marvel, the original Marvel. That thing tanked. I mean, like, tanked. That number one is on in the gutter. I don't know why, because I think that whole Marvel line is great. And I think with the multiverse, they can always bring him back. I know that they had Annette Bening play him in the Captain Marvel movie, which I love Annette Bening, but that was ridiculous. Why they would choose a woman to play a man? I mean, what's the point? What is actually the point of that? What are we trying to say? That for a woman to be successful, she has to take on the name and brand of a man? Why would you do that? I mean, look, Captain Marvel's Danvers, different because, you know, it's a race of them, right? But she didn't exist before as a man. It's kind of like if we take Carol Danvers now and make it Chris Danvers, and make him a man, and then bring back Captain Marvel as a dude. That's it. You know, everybody becomes a man. Monica Rambeau, man. Everybody, man. What would you do? What would you think of that? That's the same thing we're doing now, guys. The only difference is that it's become in style to beat up men. I personally, to be honest with you, don't give a shit. Because the reality is that, you know, it means nothing to me what other people think. So, you know, I mean, I try to do what I can to provide people with some ideas of you know, what comic collecting is, how you can have fun with the hobby. But that's it. That's what this show's about. That's what I try to communicate. I throw in Star Trek and some sci-fi all the time because I love this stuff, and I think it's kind of related. If you look at comic book conventions, they're full of fantasy and sci-fi. And the reason is because guys that are into comics like myself are usually horror, sci-fi, fantasy fans. For me, the least interesting of all is fantasy. I think once you throw magic into the equation, everything becomes easy because all you got to do is put a spell on it and it's done. So I'm not necessarily a magic guy, and that's the reason why, even with Star Wars, I even had some issues with the Force itself, only because I felt that the Force somewhat created an invincible being, and it's the same thing that happens with Superman. But I've regressed here. I'm going into other subjects that I didn't want to talk about. What I did want to talk about is about the market. Guys, listen, don't be crazy. Don't sell your stuff. Continue to buy. I'm buying in. This is the reason why that Captain America was purchased. This is the reason why that Superboy was purchased. And the reason is right now, you can get a hell of a deal. You can get a hell of a deal. And I'm here to tell you that over 50 years of comic collecting, I have never seen a recession that has affected the price of comic books beyond the price of new books that are plentiful. So if you're placing your bets, and I don't mean this out of any kind of disrespect for the hobby. I think anyone can do whatever they want, and if you can make money on it, great. But if you're placing your bets on someone is killing the children, someone, Ice Cream Man, and I'm just using those as examples because they're the most popular and the most sought after. And I think they're probably fantastic stories. But if you're placing bets on those comic books becoming iconic like Batman, Superman, Spider-Man, Fantastic Four. And you've actually, I think, are in for a big surprise. And the reason is a story is temporal. A character is endless. It's forever. It's infinitous. It's into infinity. And the reason is characters remain with us and the stories change. The story is the story. So how can you change the story? And if the book becomes famous for being the story, then it's always going to be about that book. I mean, think back. How many books are out there that have series of books after them that don't contain a major character as the linchpin? Think of Sherlock Holmes, Tarzan. I mean, Flash Gordon. Every single one of these characters has been the linchpin of why people collect something. And it's going to continue that way. So, you know, my advice to you is right now it's scary. The market looks like shit. If you sell your stuff, remember, this is a rule that you should always follow. And before I forget, because I always get to the end that I never tell anyone, please subscribe and hit the like button. So if you, you know, if you're looking at, collecting comics, I think if you want to place safe bets on newer comics, try to look for comics that no one else gives about, cares about. Believe it or not, look for, you know, sometimes children comics are a good place to look. The ones that are being done for the little kids. Like, I collected all the old Go Teen Titans Go because I had kids at the time. So I bought them all for them. I gave it to them, and then I was able to sell them. And I made a good amount of money. I mean, maybe for the entire run, a couple $100. I don't remember what it was, but I sold it as one bundle. And again, you know, I got Spider-Girl. I think it was the name when it first came out because I have a bunch of girls. So I went out and got 3 copies. I never really thought it was going to be valuable because just like it happened to all of us in the 70s, when I would see a Nova or I would see a Ghost Rider or I would see a Son of Satan or I would see any of these comics, I treated them like they were worthless, like they were dollar bin comics, because they were. At the time, they were. Ghost Rider was always pretty popular, but even then, I mean, he was pretty plentiful. He was all over the place. Everybody had a Ghost Rider. And anyone who wanted a $15 comic went out and bought Ghost Rider number 1. Because that's what it was. It was like $15. And at the time, Hulk 181, to be honest with you, nobody cared. It didn't become a hot thing until the movie. Until the X-Men movie and Wolverine exploded in popularity. I mean, people cared. Don't get me wrong. Wolverine's always been popular. But this craziness of being worth tens of thousands of dollars. I mean, if you look in the census, I think it's one of the highest number of 9.8s in the census. So anyway, guys, I wanted to show you these. Just wanted to tell you that an old adage I learned about the stock market, and I think it applies to anything you invest in, is whatever you bought and whatever your price is will not be determined until the day you sell it. So that means the market can go in the shitter right now. As long as you're not selling now, you can wait until it comes back, because there's only 2 alternatives to every solution. It's corrected or it's a disaster. Okay, if we have a disaster economically that is never going to correct the stock market within the next 3 to 4 years, I'm telling you right now, we're cutting the roofs off our cars, buying AK-47s and going down the streets hunting for food, because no way this economy and the structure of our consumer culture is going to tolerate a complete collapse of society, of the economy, without some serious political public unrest. So anyway, I think the current climate is shifting. I think the idea of having to bring down statues because they were of white men or had some meaning that someone thought was reprehensible for some reason. I mean, I'm talking about like George Washington, Thomas Jefferson. I mean, you know, just the guys who created the country, right? Trying to bring those things. It's a waste of time, guys. It's never going to last. You're never going to be able to pull that off. I mean, it may happen in 200 years where people just forget about it and don't give a shit anymore. But by force, you're never going to do it. Because you have too much of the legacy society still there in too many power positions to actually allow you to destroy it to the point that it affects them. And if you don't think it affects them, and now we're going into politics here, but why not? The economy's in the trash and it's affecting our hobby. If you don't think it affects them, it definitely affects them. Because if we start hurting the economy, the guys that are making the laws are going to start hurting. And when they start hurting, financially hurting, they're not insulated. Don't think these politicians aren't as insulated as Elon Musk, and even him, he's not that insulated. They can take some hits. But if these if the situation financially gets bad enough, which it already has, the politics of this country are going to start changing drastically. And I think we're going to see a move to be more rational rather than emotional. Because right now this country is running on pure emotion. And everything is about what makes you feel good and how are you saying something that I don't agree with and how does that make you a demon. And that shit's got to end sometime. It's going to end. We're humans. And look at our history and see if we've ever put up with that shit before. We won't put up with it again. Anyway, guys, Comic Talk out here in Miami. Looking forward to seeing you again. And I hope, I hope you learned something with shipping comics. I don't know what, but, you know, apparently even when the box isn't heard, your slab could be heard. I mean, I could possibly see how a specific fall, because the package inside the box was loose. It was wrapped in its own bubble wrap, and it was wrapped pretty good, but it was moving in the box. I could feel it slide. So possibly if it slid, some impact may have created the right level of pressure on some delicate point in that case and just shattered it. It could happen. I mean, would you expect it? No. But it can happen. So anyway, see you soon, guys. And hope you enjoyed your show.